Yeah, I mean, I showed some of this yesterday in the privacy talk already. They are focusing on the why we are doing this. This talk is more about the technical background and how we are doing this. So, yes, as I said yesterday, the competition or the problem, so to say, is the existing services around the digital driver assistant features, starting with other credit and then being more problematic with Google, who then just be pouring in there to extract this information. And what those services basically offer is they extract the travel bookings for hotels, for planes, for trains, etc. Thank you. sort of contribute to that. But with Google pushing that, it of course has gained quite some traction. And that contains like a lot of stuff, basically the data model for it's one of those semantic ontology things, so mighty inheritance and all the family mighty member of the network. But yeah, it's something in the works. And you find that in the booking has involved XML or JSON structured annotations, which makes it fairly easy to extract that. Even your transport wire actually lose those information, which is for half of the episode. If they don't, we still have regular expressions for text index as a format option. But that doesn't scale as nicely as the standard format, of course. Then there's another de facto standard for reporting passes, that's the Apple audit passes. That's essentially the file containing some JSON metadata, some translation catalogs and so on. So something that also works. And finally, there's the barcode from your typical warning pass. They also kind of standardize that we can program. Yeah, then we have static data. There's some specialized data sources like Syria, and then we have OpenStreetMap and big data. They cover everything you want. It's very freely licensed, very actively developed, very easy to edit. I mean, this is perfect, right? Because that, for that side, we are, I think, completely covered. And then we have the most problematic part, and that's the dynamic data. There's basically no free data source for this. And I also think it's very unlikely that this is ever going to change, because this relies on, for example, the feed information of the train company, right? They are the only ones with that data, and they will need to publish it. I don't see people picking up or entering delays in big data. Like, that makes no sense. So, then we will need to work with vendor APIs to do this. Those APIs actually exist. Many of them need to go free of cost, just for the database standardized. The problem there is more of a good model, I think, because they require API keys, which are of course a bit hard to deploy in free software. And they have interesting terms of conditions that might not always be compatible with what you want to do. This is one of the parts I'm hoping to get some ideas and some input here, because then you have to privacy implications to look at, and the legal side to look at, and we have operational things to look at, and one approach to this might be on a server side service on the infrastructure that talks to those services to manage the API keys and to work around all the formulating that kind of stuff and providing unified interface to our applications. But then the next step, the point of collecting data again, and we would actually need to operate server-side infrastructure for that. So I haven't found it really having a really good problem yet, so that's something to discuss. In terms of existing standards or existing data formats, the Apple Wallet passes has some very primitive update mechanism. But with that, the only thing we ever managed to obtain was the single gate change or two tons of flight. This isn't widely used in systems. And then there's the old public transport applet or puzzle, probably four times, all of those things that were lost to the transition, as David mentioned. That's using another effect standard that Google pushes for local transport, which can TTFS, which can live updates, but is designed live updates for the entire transport program. So this is not something you can directly use from mobile applications, for example. So this again will need to go through a backend system that allows us to subscribe just for the one train I'm interested in rather than all the lazy or force train. So there's a few building blocks, but this is certainly the more challenging area. So that's the theory. What do we actually have by now? There's the application that went out, what is it all about, next weekend. There's two new libraries included. The first one is KDE Pass. That's essentially just a small framework for dealing with the Apple Wallet boarding passes. So decoding the format and translating it something that can be consumed by URL or C++ code. The more interesting one is the K-Itinerary framework. That contains the data model, and that contains the instruction code. So you feed that a text file, an HTML file, a PDF file, an image of your boarding pass, whatever, and it tries to extract the booking information from that using the structured annotations at present, and otherwise adding JavaScript-based format extractors for individual providers. And then post-processes that data by augmenting this data from knowledge data to big data. That's compiled in, so no one-line access necessary for that. And that, for example, includes looking at information about train stations and airports. And so we have geocoordinates and time zones and all of that. Correct. And then we have two places where this is actually consumed already. We have the data extraction plugin in KDE. Showing my flight booking to Akademy here, which allows you to add that to your calendar, for example, or show you the destination on the map, or give you the actual check-in action that already gets you to the website and everything is within, so simplifying the workflow. The looks are a bit Oracle, because that used to be my debug output, and I got stuck. So, help is very welcome on actually making this more pretty. So, the EDG guys here. And then the second thing is the KDE itinerary Kiriyami app, which works on just a mobile or Android. And that has a timeline view of what all the data that we managed to extract. It can add weather forecast for the location you're going to be in. That requires online access, so it's optional, so you can just do that if you don't want it. Because that kind of needs to send out the location, so it's also requires a leak. Therefore, it's not very good. But it's of course the feature I want to, before leaving for trip, I need to know what the weather is going to be so I can write stuff. Those actions here allow you to open the map at that location or navigate to that location with the navigation provider. So once you arrive at the airport, this navigates you to your hotel, for example. I'm getting to that. Yeah, this is the middle one is rendering the wallet passes. And this is actually good enough to pass visual and boarding pass inspection at the airport. So I've been flying with this for almost all my flights this year. And it has the barcode that lets me pass the automatic gate scanners. And this is not images, right? This is actually rendering the raw data that's in various frameworks. This is the prison framework. So we actually know what's in there and where the data are part of it. And finally, we have the travel information extracted from the data. Maybe from the power plant component in the morning. So the first example is Switzerland, where half of my power plants are in type J sockets. So it tells me that. And then the more extreme case, of course, is the UK, where everything is incompatible. And yet, if you travel in the other directions, so the UK is your home country, it says keep on going on the right side, which is correct. we're going to change that in the final release. Those features are on Android, so it's working as well. I mean, it's actually as my results. It's apparently possible to build something like that with our limited resources. At least to the point where it's practically usable. Considerably simplified by previous paper-based workflow, so that's good. I think it's necessary. I showed you yesterday the information that KDE included just in a single booking, which is your passport, a credit card number, all of that. So stuff I want to keep private. But let's forget about that for a second. We need more test data. So far, this is very biased towards intra-European business travel. But since you probably all traveled here by plane or train somehow, if you have tickets for that, booking emails, anything vaguely related to trips. I would be very interested in that. We can, of course, look into that together so I can show you how to strip out sensitive information. This is not always easy because it's very low linear. And if it's stripped out the wrong way, we can't really test the passing against it, like the next of direction anymore, or you change the ID differently to the next. I will ask you to actually send me the raw data if you don't want to. Just grab it on the email and actually can swallow the interesting bits. And another aspect is this is essentially just building blocks, right? This is not the ultimate solution. It's a whole bunch of stuff where this needs to be integrated. Minecraft comes to mind, then there is the public transport. Plus, more if you revive that, or Marvel, possibly. That's why this is libraries and building blocks that that can combine with your application. And there's definitely more than that. But yeah, that's for now.
Any questions? Yeah, Right. Then the sound spread, can I add also part of my tips which I don't have, in the ticket system? For example, if I have a frequent traveler ticket for a certain part, I can just look up in, on a public transport site or app and add it?
We have some basic editing support already that is just being worked on, but it's probably not there yet. The integration with the with apps like Transporter for the public, like non-train specific regular public transport, this would be awesome to have, especially between the various steps you had to. So between arriving at the airport in Vienna and going to the hotel, I would like to have a major schedule that I did. That's very good of this to go, yes. So if we can actually use Booking so far is out of scope because while I travel a lot, I rarely book stuff myself, so I don't know which to scratch there. I haven't really looked in if there's standard APIs. There must be some because the travel agencies use that as well. Regarding calendar integration, I mean, they quickly showed up on the calendar plugin. It allows you to extract and stuff to your calendar. You need to do that explicitly, unlike Google, you don't do that automatically. And it adds the event to the calendar, but it also attaches the structure data to that event. So, to get it on my own phone, I switch that via Xcloud, and the app reads before the calendar again. So, I think calendar is the other way. That's what it's still existing. But it also makes sense by navigating to the meeting actually going to. Integration.